Now, this video is about septic tanks as an alternative means of toilet wastewater management. Greenhouse biodigesters. On this channel, we do videos that explain how biodigesters work and how you can use it as an option in managing your greenhouse. A septic tank basically works in such a way that you have to have chambers done. It can be three chambers. Ideally, what I've known over the years that the best chambers that work for septic tanks are the three chambers, where there's the first chamber, and then there's the second chamber, and then there's the third chamber. So there's an overflow tank to a level whereby after the solid settles down, you can have the water going into the next chamber, and then it can also settle down, and then it can go into the third chamber. Then there's a soakaway where the wastewater can be floated slowly into the air surface. Because the bottom of the septic tank is sealed, most of the time, the human waste will have to settle. If you're lucky and the water goes into your soakaway and then the ground is good enough and is able to soak the water, then obviously it will last you a longer time. Then you don't have to worry because then human waste or the solubles will settle down and then it can break down slowly and then it can become like sand at the base of it. Some people have used septic tanks over the years and they've not had any problem, but mostly depending on the area in which the property is located and the type of soil that they meet when the septic tank is done. On the other hand, if you are not able to get the wastewater or the water to be soaked into the ground, then it means that you will need a truck to come and help you dislodge it periodically. The problem I've realized over the years is that most people have a shorter timeline for the dislodging, and that's what becomes the problem for them. Because if you have to dislodge every 3 months or every 6 months, and the cost that you are going to incur in dislodging is 500 or 600 cedis, considering how long you're going to live in that house and the number of people who are going to be using it, and then how many times you have to dislodge in a year, all will go to affect your budget. So those are the considerations that most people will make. And because of the amount of work involved in constructing a septic tank, it might take you like 1 week, some take 2 weeks, some take 3 weeks. Because when you do the concrete at the base, you are required to leave it for it to dry enough before the blocks are laid on it. And then you need your iron rods for the top cover to cast it so that it can become firm and then it might not sink in. Space required for a septic tank is key. The kind of space that you need for a septic tank is key. And the installation time, the number of weeks or days it might take you to have it constructed will also come in place. Now, when you do construct the septic tank, you also need to make sure that the space or the depth is important when it comes to septic tanks. Septic tanks works in such a way that the water and the human waste are going to stay together in the same place, which means that the deeper, the better. If you have enough feet going down with dug wall, you'll be able to dig 20 feet or 15 feet, and they do not meet water, then the better for you. It means that it will take you a long time for two things to happen. Either the human waste likely will settle down slowly for you, and then the soakaway will work well, whereby it will not come to the top for you to get full, and that will require you needing a truck to come and dislodge. And the second thing is, the longer the human waste stays in the septic tank, the better it's able to break down to a level whereby it can settle at the base, and then the water can go into the overflow tank, and then it can go into the soakaway for disposal, for the soakaway to do its part of the work. So that's one of the key things when it comes to septic tanks that in case you are going to construct a septic tank, you are supposed to look out for. You are also supposed to take into account the environment that is being done. You also mean that the more sandy the soil is, the better it is for you. If it's a clay area, well, it's not bad. But if it's a waterlogged area, it means that it's possible for leakage to happen. Another good thing about septic tank is that if it's constructed well, all the pipes that are coming from the house, whenever you have to lay them, will not be a problem. Because if the septic tank is 15 feet or 20 feet deep, or let's say 10 feet, and the pipes that the plumber is laying from the house is coming into the septic tank, will come and fall, let's say at the base, at 3 feet or 2 feet or 4 feet even, it's not a problem for you, because then you can do your pavement in the house, and then those pipes can be buried, because most people do not like their pipes showing when they construct when they are doing the compound. They prefer the pipes all to be buried underground. And septic tank works in this situation well, because then the pipes can always be buried. The type of seed that you're going to use it's also not a problem. You can decide to use your P-trap or you can use your S-trap, because then the pipe can be buried. And then even if it's taking up to 4 feet to go into the septic tank, it's not going to be a problem, because there's enough chamber or enough space at the base for human waste to come and for the water itself to come to a level before you might require dislodging. If your soakaway is working well, then it means that you do not have a problem when you do construct a septic tank.